red flags over the coaching center that were raised earlier were ignored. We're learning a student has now come forward and has said that the complaint was raised to the MCD about illegal basement in the coaching center, but no action was taken. MCD's glaring lapses are now exposed, and we're learning the student who's now come forward has said that he had complained to the MCD, written a letter also about the illegal basements operating in the Rajinder Nagar area in the coaching centers, but these complaints were ignored. All right, listening to that student who had flagged this issue earlier. Well, that is the big breaking news now coming in. We'll try and get more details about this in just a bit. Day after sudden flooding in the basement of an IAS coaching center in Delhi had killed 3 students, the MCD also sealed 13 coaching centers in the old Rajinder Nagar area that were found flouting the rules. Well, the Delhi mayor has also informed that searches were conducted at several coaching centers on Sunday, and the MCD sealed the institutes that were running commercial activities in the basement. Well, this also comes after the mayor had directed the MCD commissioner to take strict action against all coaching centers across Delhi that are under the jurisdiction of the civic body and were running commercial activities in the basements, violating the laws. But the question here is, isn't this too little too late? Well, 3 students died after the basement of Rao's IAS study circle was flooded. The FIR that has been registered in the case clearly says that the clogged drains at the coaching center area as was the reason for the flooding of the basement. All right, my colleague Tanushka is also now joining us on the broadcast. She is getting us more from the ground. She's outside the Rajinder Nagar coaching center where these protests have been taking place. Tanushka, show us around. What is happening at the moment? What is the situation?
Right, exactly, Kitty, as you rightly mentioned, you know, a lot has been happening. Students are still here protesting. There's a small memoriam that they have, the students, the UPSC aspirants themselves have only created in memory of the 3 students who passed away, that is Tanya, Shreya and Nevin. And the students here are currently on a peaceful protest here. We know that the 2 arrests have been made of the owner as well as the coordinator of the coaching center, and they've been sent into 14 days of judicial custody. NDTV has also managed to get speaking with one of the teachers here. This is, you know, one of the first very few teaching faculty of one of the coaching centers here who's present in solidarity with the students. Let us get talking to him. Hello sir, could you please tell us your name?
Santosh Kumar.
All right, and for how many years have you been teaching as a faculty?
I've been teaching since last 6 years.
All right, and this sort of a tragedy that has gone down, you know, You've been closely associated with these students 6 years, you said, as a faculty, and you here as, you know, a teacher itself, you know, what is the message you want to give across?
One thing that I'll say is, no matter in which part of the country you go, most of the places where students live, they live in a very unsafe environment. Be it if you walk through the roads of ORN, I've been living in old Rajinder Nagar since last 10 years, and on every road there are wires hanging. On every road you'll find, I have myself studied in libraries which are in basement, and after this accident I realized how unsafe that could have been. Instead of those students, it could have been in the past, it could have been me only. So that's something which is happening in every city, be it Pune, be it Delhi, where students' interest is not being taken care of. And most of the time what happens is, in this area, students are not the voters. They come from different part of the country. And this is the scenario everywhere, be it in Kota, be it Pune. So what I would like to tell everyone, or what I would like to request is, we have to ensure that wherever these people are living, there is every aspect of security gets taken care of there.
You know, the MCD has also taken action now by sealing down 13 of these, coaching centers that were operating libraries in their basement. But 3 lives have been lost. So do you, believe that this was an avoidable tragedy, or this is a crime of negligence?
This was definitely an avoidable tragedy. We should not in any way had students or libraries in basements. Like, this could have been completely avoided, and everyone is to be blamed, be it the authorities, be it the institution, or be it the teachers, I would say. Ki, they should have also said, ki, why are you running this thing in the basement?
Thank you so much. Yeah.
Mains exam, right? I have a mains exam just 50 days after, okay, on 20th of September, right? And I'm sitting right here. Every day cost to me. Every day I can revise the syllabus, but I have to sit here. The reason is that I sit in the library, okay? I come at the 7 in the morning from Noida. I mean, today also I'm coming from Noida because I want to show the solidarity. Okay, our library has been closed. Where should I stay? Okay, so problem is that, I mean, you put that QR scan code.
Yeah.
Sometimes that doesn't work, and that's what happened here.
Yeah, exactly.
Right, because people are not able to come out. The second question is that, are you meeting the proper checks and valences? Sometimes fire happens. I'm coming right from that area. You see there, go there, and you see there are so many wires over there. 3 days, 4 days back, somebody died.
Right.
So it can happen to any of us. What proper checks and valences you're taking? Third question is that, why every time a student needs to come out? 3 days we are sitting in the protest, and then MCT commissioner is coming out yesterday night.
Right.
Everybody can't do that. We don't have that luxury, you know. We are examination process. We cannot loot our days.
Yeah,
so
I can see you've come with your notes and preparation as well. So
15 days are left.
Yeah.
Right, how can I do that? Every day will cost me my rank. Right, I can be out of the list.
Right.
And this is my... So, they have to understand it.
Speaking of solidarity, you said, you know, the coaching center has also issued a notice in which they've also said that they also, you know, stand in solidarity with the students. What would you say about that, considering that this happened because of their greediness, if I may put that?
No, I mean, we don't want their solidarity, okay? They don't have to put the solidarity. The question is that they have to act preemptively, right? That such incident should not happen further. What they are doing that? Why they have not installed the proper checks and balances? There can be a fire, there can be, you know, earthquake, etc. Do they have the proper checks and balances? Exit gate, etc. Why this is happening? You don't, I mean, just somebody died, two people died, and you're showing that, you're showing solidarity. This is absolutely ridiculous. The MLA should come. MLA has not been here. You know, that MCD commissioner is coming, right? So this is absolutely not good. They are our representative. You know, a commissioner is not our representative.
All right. Thank you so much for that. So pertinent questions here being raised by the UPSC aspirants here, as well as, of course, the teacher also, teaching faculty who's present here, that questions about accountability, questions about who is to, you know, take the blame now. Yes,
right,
there has
okay.
been some sort of a movement in the case, but it does not really compensate for the loss of these three lives that happened out of sheer negligence on part of not just the coaching authority here, but also the, you know, the government authorities in the area,
yeah,
the municipality as well.
Between the Aam Aadmi Party and the BJP also. The BJP is also staging protests. And today also we are expecting that the BJP workers and leaders are going to stage protests outside the Aam Aadmi Party office. That is the information coming out. All right, my colleague Ishika now joins us on the broadcast. She is getting us more on that. Ishika, we are also learning now more information coming in that Delhi police is also expected to question the MCD officials and officials who were responsible for the drainage system in the old Rajinder Nagar area. With that, the war of words between the Aam Aadmi Party and the BJP has also escalated. The political fight has also now erupted over this issue. Action, of course, is being taken, but as we've been speaking about it, this has come at a cost. At, you know, all right, Ishika, I'm being told I'll have to come to you later. I'm being told that we have the reaction from that student, that soundbite where that student earlier had said that he had complained to the MCD earlier, he had filed the complaint, but no action was taken on the complaint that was filed. Listen into what he had to say.
Yeah, actually, issue ye hai ki yahan pe most of these jitni bhi buildings hain, jaise main agar kisi building mein reh raha hun, to uski puri building ki entry aur exit jo hai, wo biometrics se control hoti hai. तो उसमें कैसे है कि और हमारा मतलब कंसर्न ये है कि अगर सपोज़ कुछ इमरजेंसी हो जाती है, आग लग जाती है या कैसे भी कुछ कोई भी इमरजेंसी हो जाती है, तो पूरे बिल्डिंग में कोई भी बालकनी नहीं है, कोई बिल्डिंग में कोई भी ऐसी जगह नहीं है कि अगर हम लोग किसी को इमरजेंसी नंबर पे कॉल करते हैं, कोई आता है कि हम लोग को रेस्क्यू कर लो, तो रेस्क्यू करने का उनके पास कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है. क्योंकि इमरजेंसी की वजह से कि अगर वो गेट के पास कोई इमरजेंसी होती है तो हम लोग अगर ऊपर हैं तो हम लोग नीचे आ नहीं सकते, और अगर कोई बाहर है तो वो अंदर आ नहीं सकता क्योंकि बायोमेट्रिक की वजह से वो लॉक हो गया है.